Good morning. It's a joy to share together on this Pentecost Sunday, a special day in the life of the church. So glad that you are here. Glad to have some of my family here this morning. We're celebrating a special day. We're baptizing our daughter Jane this morning, and then this afternoon up at Lake Junaluska, I'm going to be ordained as an elder in the church. And so it's kind of a special day, and glad to have some family here with us this morning. Thank you all. Next Sunday, we are going to have a pastor's farewell luncheon for Dave's family and me and my family. We're going to have that right after the 11 o'clock service, and so I hope that you can come and bring a dish to share. We're looking forward to that time together next week. If you'd like to honor someone special in your life, you can give to our children's renovation project. We're redoing the children's hall downstairs, and so if you would like to honor somebody, you can go to our website, keithumc.org/renovation-donation, and you can give there. We're really looking forward to that renovation, and so I hope that everyone can pitch in to make that happen. And if you'd like to support the ministries of our church, there's a number of ways you can do that. You can give in the offering plate. You can text to give. There's a number listed there in your bulletin. You can give online, or you can mail in your check. So this time, let us now prepare our hearts and minds for worship as we go to the Lord in prayer. Holy Spirit, come forth this day and pour out your power among us. As we gather this morning, we ask that you would open our hearts to receive your love and grace in our lives. And may we also find ways to reach out to others and make a difference in their lives as well. For it's in your name we pray. Amen.
Would you stand with us as you're able this morning?
God sent his son, they call him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my sin.
All fear is That song was a special request from Allie on this day of Jane's baptism. My favorite line in that is how sweet it is to hold a newborn baby, which I get to do here momentarily. So it's a time to celebrate Jane's baptism. And so on the screen, we'll be able to follow along with that. So, brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of holy baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We're incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All of this is God's gift offered to us without price. And so it is a joy today to present Jane McKenzie Lay for baptism. I'd like to invite you all to come up. And ask you the questions that have been asked of parents down through the generations. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior? Put your whole trust in His grace and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races. Will you nurture Jane in Christ's holy church that by your teaching and example she may be guided to accept God's grace for herself, to profess her faith openly, and to lead a Christian life? I assumed you would, but just have to ask. So do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life and include Jane now before you in your care? With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround Jane with a community of love and forgiveness, that she may grow in her trust of God and be found faithful in her service to others. We will pray for her that she may be a true disciple who walks in the way that leads to life. And let us join now together in professing the Christian faith as it's contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the Holy Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Lord be with you. Let us pray. Eternal Father, when nothing existed but chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth light. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water. After the flood, you set in the clouds a rainbow. When you saw your people as slaves in Egypt, you led them to freedom through the sea. Their children you brought through the Jordan to the land which you promised. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Tell of God's mercy each day. In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus, nurtured in the water of a womb. He was baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection and to make disciples of all nations. Declare his works to the nations, his glory among all the people. Pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and she who receives it, to wash away her sin and clothe her in righteousness throughout her life, that dying and being raised with Christ, she may share in his final victory. All praise to you, eternal Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit
lives and reigns forever. Amen.
Here we go. Come on, Jane. All right.
Jane McKenzie Lay, receive your baptism in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And may the Spirit of God work through your heart and life all your life long, and confirm and strengthen you as a disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 You want to go see your new family in Jesus? All right. Look around. Oh, those pretty blue eyes. Here she is. Can you see? Look around at all these folks. Yeah. All right. She's a little not. She's like a little uncertain what this is involving. So, you mean these people? Yeah. And a lot more besides. Oh. Hey, hi there. Bless you. Hi there. Oh, how about that? Yeah. Oh. Y'all can just go be seated now. I've got this. No, I'm just kidding. How about that? Awesome. All right. Yeah. Oh, that's sweet. How about that? Oh, very good. Very good. Thank you. Wow. Well, I think I could just hold her forever. So, yeah. Thank you. She is precious. Did y'all see? Cindy, miss her. Did you see this? There we go. Awesome. Very good. Oh, there we go. Oh, very good. What a precious, precious little girl. Blessings and grace upon you. Amen. All right. Ready? It's okay. Hey there. There we go. All right. There we go. Awesome. Thank you. All right. Thank you. Amen. Bless you. And then we have a certificate of this special day that we'd like to present to you. Thank you so much. And you know, you have made these promises not only on your own behalf as this congregation where they have been married and have received Jane into their home and family and into this world. You're kind of making these promises on behalf of other churches that they will share and serve and live among, and so that is a joy. And so, members of the household of God, I commend Jane to your love and to your care. So do all in your power to increase her faith, confirm her hope, and perfect her in love. We give thanks for all that God has already given you, and we welcome you in Christian love, as members together with you in the body of Christ and in this congregation of the United Methodist Church, we renew our covenant faithfully to participate in the ministries of the church by our prayers, our presence, our gifts, and our service, and our witness, that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. Amen. Blessings upon you.
We have now come to our prayer time this morning, and what a joy it is to be able to share in this special baptism this morning. Special to me as well. We also had some wonderful baptisms last Sunday. We went down to the river and had a number of folks, and so I'm not sure if everyone's here or not, but I've got certificates. So Jalen Coffey, she was baptized in the river. Sarah Thomas, Cameron Zemer, and Matt Zemer, we're all baptized. So if you are here, come up and get your certificate. So congratulations to you too, yeah. So what a joy that is to be able to share in that holy sacrament this morning. It's also a joy this past week when we had our vacation Bible school. And I want to thank Reagan Kelly for kind of putting that together and everybody who helped volunteer. There's so many people who were involved in doing that. And so thank y'all for putting your time in over the weekend to do that. I know the kids had a lot of fun. It ended with a slip and slide and cookout. So great way to end Vacation Bible School, but it was a wonderful time this past weekend. The youth are going on a junior high service week trip to Camp Lookout. And so that's an opportunity for the kids to be able to do some of the camp activities, but also to get involved in some service projects in the community up there. So we're going to pray for them at the end of our service, but we want to remember them this morning as a joy. And I know Reagan is going to be up there on staff. So Connor Soulsby is also there on staff. So we got a good connection to Camp Lookout. So we just want to remember Camp Lookout over the time this summer in our prayers as well. And, of course, we've got annual conference coming up this week that we're looking forward to. So please just be in prayer for all our clergy, lady that are going to be up there voting, making decisions for our conference for our church. And so we're looking forward to that time. Any other joys or celebrations we can share this morning? Yes. That's amazing. That's amazing. Absolutely. Absolutely. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Affects a lot of people. And so thank you all for sharing that testimony. 1 year of sobriety, that is a joy. That is a celebration. Any other joys? Any other celebrations? Happy birthday. All right. He's excited about it, but happy birthday, Mike. Others. Well, I know we have a number of folks that we want to continue to lift up on the back of your bulletin. You can see a list, our prayer list. I hope that you will take that with you and pray for these folks throughout the week. Are there others that we need to lift up in prayer? Other concerns? Yes, Becky. Jim Floyd, we'll lift him up as he battles cancer, deals with that diagnosis. Thank you. Any other concerns? Do any of us have unspoken requests, which we would acknowledge by the lifting of our hands this morning? As always, you can let us know how we can lift you up in prayer. You can come talk to us after the service. You can call us at the church office. You can email us at prayer@keithumc.org, but we're always happy to know how we can come alongside you in your joys and in your concerns. Let us now go to the Lord in prayer. God of the Father, God of the Son, God of the Holy Spirit, we gather together on this Pentecost Sunday, remembering that you are a God that equips and empowers us. May your Holy Spirit reign over us this day so that we may be filled with passion as we seek to do your work in this place. Oh God, when we fail, your Holy Spirit is there to act as our guide. Allow us to accept your offer of forgiveness for our sins and transgressions, and may your Spirit be our source of comfort and peace. May we be forgiven for the many ways in which we fail to do your will, and the ways that we fail to reach out to the lost, the lonely, and the hurting in our world. Lord, we thank you for all the many blessings that you have given to us. We celebrate this morning remembering how you give us good gifts, good things in this life. We thank you for the special gift of your baptism, which washes us with your prevenient grace. We thank you on this Pentecost Sunday as we think about the baptism of the Holy Spirit, which births us into this church. May we embrace this gift of grace throughout our life's journey. This morning we also think of many who are struggling with difficult situations and circumstances, those that are victims of gun violence, those who are dealing with addiction and depression, those who are experiencing great loss and hardship. And we ask that you might bring about your healing, comfort, and peace. May you provide us all with your Holy Spirit as we strive to be a faithful church, and allow us to find ways to renew our relationship with you as we also seek to find restoration in our relationships with one another. May we go forth this week and experience your love in a powerful and meaningful way. For we ask these things in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We have baskets in the back and baskets up here in the front, and you're invited to come and bring your offering. And when you do, you can also light a candle and kneel in prayer. So let's continue our worship this morning.
Good morning, everybody. So this past weekend, we had our VBS. It was Passport to Peace, so hence the globes. And we learned about what it means to be a peacemaker. Does anybody up here remember the verse and can recite it for us? Georgia, you want to?
You've heard people say, love your neighbors and hate your enemies. But I say, love your enemies and pray for people that have mistreated you.
And we wanted to bring the VBS fun to you all, so we're going to teach you all our favorite dance to our song, God is a Good God. So I'll need y'all's help by standing up and following these kids' lead for the dance, okay? So now you all need to spread out in front of the, spread all the way down. We've got this whole front. Come on, Rhett. Keep on walking. Everybody needs to see ya. Keep on. We got people over here that need to see the dance. Yeah, some of y'all stay over there. This is very easy. It's very repetitive, and these kids are pros at it. So, and then after the dance, I need y'all to stay up here for me, okay? So here we go. I think we're ready back there.
God is a good God. Yes, God is. 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 God lifts you up and turns you around. God sets your feet on higher ground. God is a good God. Yes, God is. 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 God gives you peace. God gives you joy. This whole world cannot destroy. God is a good God. Yes, God is. 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 God made the moon. God made the stars. God made the sun and chocolate bars. God is a good God. Yes, God is. God is a good God. Yes, God is. God is a good God. Yes, God is. God is a good God. Yes, God is.
Awesome. You all can be seated. But my VBS friends, I have something. I just wanted to recognize everybody who came. So we have Mr. Rec Belk. Here you go. There's your boarding pass for Passport to Peace. Miss Abby Rucker. Mr. Mason Rucker. Hannah Hedrick. Harper Hedrick. Oh, let me come around. Georgia Sumner. Miss Hollis, Mr. Luke, we've got Henry over here, we've got Carl Mason, and we've got Mr. Frank Evan. Everybody give them a round of applause. Awesome. Let's get back to our seats. Thank y'all.
Hollis called me out. I just want to clarify, I can't dance. Got to hold this guitar. You can't dance when you have to hold the guitar.
Spirit of the
Our scripture for today comes from Paul's letter to the Ephesians from the third chapter. It's a prayer that's kind of right in the heart of this letter. And so I'm going to read this from Eugene Peterson's paraphrase in The Message, because I think on Pentecost Sunday it really sparkles with the language and imagery. So hear now the Word of God from Ephesians chapter 3. My response is to get down on my knees before the Father, this magnificent Father, who parcels out all heaven and earth. I ask Him to strengthen you by His Spirit, not a brute strength, but a glorious inner strength, that Christ will live in you as you open the door and invite Him in. And I ask Him that with both feet planted firmly on love, you'll be able to take in with all followers of Jesus the extravagant dimensions of Christ's love. Reach out and experience the breadth, test its length, plumb the depths, rise to the heights. Live full lives, full in the fullness of God. God can do anything, you know, far more than you could ever imagine or guess or request in your wildest dreams. He does it not by pushing us around, but by working within us, His Spirit deeply and gently within us. Glory to God in the church. Glory to God in the Messiah, in Jesus. Glory down all the generations. Glory through all millennia. Oh, yes. This is the Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. So, today is a big day. It's Pentecost. It's traditionally observed as the sort of the birthday of the church. It's the day that God's Holy Spirit descended upon the disciples who were gathered there in Jerusalem and gave them the power and the ability to share the good news about Him all around the world. That's great. We have the globes up here from Bible school. It's the day of Jane's baptism and the joy that is in their family. And it's also the day of Andrew's ordination, as he mentioned, this evening over at Lake Junaluska. First time we will have gathered together as an annual conference since 2019, at which time Andrew was commissioned as a provisional elder in the conference. And so now he's ordained as a full elder, which for like teacher folks, that means he's got tenure. He's tenured. So that's right. So it's a big day. And so I was thinking about what's a scripture that sort of might speak into this day? And I was drawn to this passage of Paul's letter to the Ephesians. And this prayer that again, is right at the center of this letter. Paul's letter to the Ephesians is bookended, begins and ends with prayer. But there's this beautiful prayer right in the middle that sort of separates the two halves of the letter. And I want this to be a prayer for Andrew on this day of his ordination as an elder in the church. I want it to be a prayer for Jane on this day of her baptism into the church, and a prayer for the church, this church and Christ's church around the world on this day of Pentecost. And so I'm hopeful Andrew appreciates that this scripture comes from Ephesians, because Ephesians was a favorite letter of the founders of Methodism, John and Charles Wesley. This is a letter that emphasizes our salvation by God's grace through faith in Christ. And that is a theme that Andrew emphasizes in his preaching. Don't worry, Jane, I'll have you out here in just a second. So it emphasizes God's grace, but it also emphasizes our unity in Christ from all the different ways and places we come to Christ, that we are one in Christ, which is, again, something that Andrew emphasizes in his preaching. For several years, I've kind of had a personal mission statement from the Scripture. Someone had said, you should have a mission statement. And so I kind of was reading through, and I finally, after a while, found a statement that sort of speaks into my life and my ministry. And it comes from Paul's words to the elders at the church in Ephesus. But it doesn't come from this letter. It's actually found in the book of Acts, chapter 20. And it's verse 28, and that verse reads like this: "Keep watch over yourselves and over all the flock of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to shepherd the church of God that He obtained with the blood of His own Son." That's a lot. It's a mouthful. But it starts off, keep watch over yourselves and over the flock that the Holy Spirit's given you. And I just share that with Andrew. I think I've shared that with him before as something he might want to borrow. That's something that we do to kind of keep watch of our own selves, our own spiritual lives, before we can then care for the spiritual lives of the flocks to which the Spirit has appointed us. It's kind of like when you get on an airplane and you're told, you know, if in the case of an emergency, put on your own mask first, and then you can put on the masks of others. Keep watch over yourselves and then over the flock. But this prayer in Ephesians, it starts off with a bit of wordplay in Greek, which maybe you all will find, you know, I enjoy that. It starts off, I bow before the Father, pater in Greek, from whom all families, or literally fatherhoods, patria, take its name, which is a reminder that that his fatherhood, our parenthood is a reflection of God's fatherhood, God's parenthood of all of us. And so we have an opportunity in our homes and families to reflect God's love for all of us in the ways in which we love our families. But it goes on to pray that I would pray for Andrew, that he may continue to be strengthened by the power of God's Spirit, this Holy Spirit, this Spirit of Pentecost. And I like how Eugene Peterson puts it, that the Spirit gives us not a brute strength, but a glorious inner strength. And I think that's an inner strength that Andrew exudes. Goes on to pray that he would have his feet firmly planted in love. And they would go on to grasp with all the followers of Jesus the extravagant dimensions of Christ's love, the height and depth and the length and the breadth, the full dimensions of God's love for us in Christ. And even, it ends like this, even with all that Andrew has already accomplished in his life and ministry, he's got a podcast, The Methodical Methodist, which if you haven't listened to it, it's awesome. He talks about John and Charles Wesley a lot. He's written a book of Advent devotions that still this God is able to accomplish far more than he or Allie could ever ask or imagine or envision in their life and ministry together. That God would continue to work in and through them in unbelievable ways. So I pray that to do so in the Spirit working within them, I love how Peterson puts it, deeply and gently. I think that those adverbs sort of share the quality that Andrew has in his ministry, the Spirit working in his heart and life deeply and gently. So may this be a prayer for Andrew on this day of his ordination. But also a prayer for Jane, wherever in the world, in the church she is today. Because her baptism is actually her ordination into the general ministry of the church. If you've been baptized in Christ, you've been ordained in a way. That our baptism is all of our ordination into the ministry of the church that Christ calls all of us to share. And so this is a big day, an important day for her. And I think it's appropriate that this prayer of Paul's, scholars believe, was originally used as a part of the baptismal liturgy in the early church. So it's fitting that we look at this prayer today. And it's a prayer that she too would be strengthened by the power of God's Holy Spirit in her life. She's got spirit. I mean, you know that, right? You've seen that. And with a mama like Allie, you know she's gonna have some spirit, right? She's spirited. It goes on to say that Christ would come to dwell in her heart and in her life through faith. When she opens the door of her heart and invites Jesus in, it reminds us that this day, her baptism day, later on, someday, be confirmed by herself, by her own profession of faith, on the day of her confirmation, years down the road, that she may make this profession of faith herself, and that she would come to take in with all of the followers of Jesus. Again, the extravagant dimensions of Christ's love. I want to read that part again from the message. Reach out and experience the breadth. Test its length. Plumb the depths. Rise to the heights. Live full lives. full in the fullness of God. May she live such a full life. One of my favorite TV shows has been This Is Us. Any This Is Us fans out there? Okay, yeah, This Is Us. It's sort of the story of parents and three children and their lives and their families across time and generations. And they just finished up the series. It was 6 seasons, so 6 of my 7 years, I've been watching this show. And several years ago now, in 2017, we had a sermon series based on This Is Us, of Genesis, the book of Genesis, and how all the weird and wild family stories in Genesis, I mean, are weird and wild family stories of us. This Is Us. And so, anyway, love this show. But in the next to last scene of the very last episode, which came out 2 Tuesdays ago, it's a flashback to the time when the three children were probably preteens. And it's sort of a lazy Saturday afternoon. It's raining, so they're inside, and they're playing pin the tail on the donkey. And Kate, the girl in the threesome, they've blindfolded her. They're spinning her this way, and then they spin her that way. And then she makes her way slowly but confidently right to the donkey and pins the tail right in the perfect place. And the rest of her family are like, wow, how did you do that? How do you do that? How do you always do that? And she said to them, she said, before you blindfold me, I look around and I see where you are. And because you never shut up, I know where you are, and as long as I know where you are, I always know where I'm going. I pray that Andrew and Allie never shut up talking about God's grace and God's love for Jane and for everyone in all the world. And I hope that all the churches that they're a part of never shut up talking about God's grace and love for all people. Because as long as they never shut up, Jane will know who she is, she will know where she is, and she will always know where she's going. It's also prayer for this church, Christ's church all around, but especially for Keith Church, that this church would be strengthened by the power of the same Holy Spirit in some of the same ways. That the church would always be rooted and grounded in love. Love, the love we're to have for God, the love we're to have for one another in Christ. And that this church may have the power, as Paul puts it, to comprehend with all the saints. And there have been some mighty fine saints that have been here in this church to comprehend with all the saints what is the depth and the length and the height and breadth. All these four dimensions of Christ's love. Some ancient interpreters have heard these four dimensions as a reference to the cross, and how the arms of the cross reach out to extend, to embrace everyone. And they reach down into the depths of death and even hell itself. And it shows the lengths to which God would go at the cross and soars to the heights even of heaven itself. And that we all would come to know the broad expanse of that love for us. And I continue to pray that the life and ministry of this church would continue to be formed and shaped in this cruciform way, in this cross-shaped way, and would come to continue to fulfill the vision that this church and the leadership of this church discerned back in the fall. And it's on the front of our bulletin, and it's on the screen, this vision of expanding the reach of this church for Christ in this community, reaching up to God in worship and praise, reaching over to one another in care and in concern, and reaching out to all people, everyone, in love and in service to others. That the Spirit would continually expand your reach for Christ. Now, I know that it might seem that the church is not in a season of expansion, but maybe more in a season of contraction. We've moved in the last several months from from three worship services on a Sunday to two, and we're moving from two pastors to one pastor. And so it can kind of seem like we're in a season of contraction. But, and that may be so. That may be true for a season. But I want to suggest to you that I believe that the best days of Keith Church are not necessarily behind you. That the best days of this church may very well be ahead of you. Now you might ask me, Graybill, how on earth can you make such a claim? In a day and time of where church attendance is dropping, the denominations going through turmoil, how can you say that? And the reason I can say that is that I believe in the God of this prayer. God of this prayer that ends by reminding us, God can do anything, you know? God can do anything. God can do far more than any of us can ever ask or imagine or envision. God can do amazing and astounding things through the power of God's Holy Spirit working within you, within all of us, deeply and gently. To that God be all glory and praise, and to Jesus Christ, and to all generations. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us pray together. Holy Spirit of God, you hovered over the waters at the creation of the universe. You kindled a fire in the hearts of the prophets that wouldn't be quenched until they spoke your word to your people. And in the fullness of time, you came upon your servant Mary, and you conceived your own son in her womb. You brought to birth the long-awaited Messiah to your people. You anointed him at his baptism. You empowered his ministry among us of healing the sick, of teaching your way, and of showing your love, and of saving us all. On the day of Pentecost, your Spirit fell upon your disciples gathered together, and you gave them the power to shine with the light of your life, to share the love of Christ all around the world. And so, Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on your church this day to strengthen your church for our ministry in this community and throughout the world, working deeply and gently within all of us. And so sanctify now these gifts that we share together, these gifts of bread and juice. By your Spirit, transform us into your living, breathing, loving body of Christ, giving of ourselves and serving others just as Jesus has done. Lord, bind us together in holy communion with you and with one another through your Holy Spirit in Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, this is the body of Christ, broken for you and for me, for the life of the world. This is the cup of Christ, poured out for you and for me and for many for the forgiveness of sins. We have life in his love. Friends, as we come together to share communion with one another, we would like to invite you. Andrew and I will have some bread here. You're welcome to come down the center and receive the bread. And then on your way back to your seat, when you get to your seat, I hope you have one of these prepackaged communion sets. If you don't, there are plenty in a basket just outside this door here. And then when you return to your seat, you're welcome to take in the bread and the juice, the body and the blood, the life and the love of Christ as we commune together in His Holy Spirit with Him and with one another. All are welcome to come and to receive these gifts of God. These are not ours to give. These are Jesus's to give. And Jesus wants all to come and share. So you're welcome to come and receive these gifts of God for God's people.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
In your high mission team, who will be leaving this tomorrow, to come forward. We'd like to offer a word of blessing upon you. And Mark, if you're here as well, if Mark is here. All right. These folks are going down to Camp Lookout, leaving tomorrow. Be spending the week down there, doing all kinds of different things, working in, I know last year works at one of the tent cities down in Chattanooga area, maybe doing some other things, maybe making some visits. I think anything, Mark, that you know of that they're planning to do? It's kind of a surprise. So so you're open to whatever, in whatever way God is going to be leading you this week. So this is tremendous. Thank you so much in your middle school years for being missionaries for Christ out in the world. You already are in your schools and in the community, but this is a special way for you all to come together this week. The bonds that you will form with one another, with other folks from around this area. I think it's going to be a wonderful week of fellowship and service together. So let's pray. And I would just like invite you all to just extend your hands upon in their direction as sort of a way of praying God's blessing upon them. And let's pray together. Let's pray. Gracious God, I thank you for these young people in our church. Thank you for all the ways in which you have been at work in their hearts and in their lives, nurturing their faith and trust in you and in one another. I thank you for Mark and for the leadership that he has provided to this group, for the example that he has set among them. We ask your blessing to be upon them as they journey now this week down to Camp Lookout to be of service in whatever way you would set before them opportunities to show and to share your love and your life in Jesus Christ. May your blessing be upon them. Keep them safe in all that they're doing. Draw them closer to you, closer to one another, through the Spirit of Jesus Christ, the Spirit of Pentecost. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Go in God's grace and peace. Amen. Oh, okay. Abby and Amelia is also going with, and Abby Carroll too, so the adult who will be with them as well. So all of us, we are all sent as missionaries into the world. Let us go. Let us go as representatives and ambassadors of Christ to show and share His love. And may God's Spirit fill our hearts and lead us forward in Christ's name.